Welcome students in my maths step by step class. In today's fraction part 15 we will do subtraction of unlike and mixed fraction. So yesterday we have done subtraction of like fractions. So today we will do subtraction of unlike and mixed fraction. See, so I have taken first question. Question is 1 upon 2 minus 1 upon 3. 1 upon 2 minus 1 upon 3. So see, first we have to check the fraction whether it is like or unlike. So as I have told you in previous classes in fraction that we can never add or subtract unlike fractions. Every time we have to check first. If fractions are unlike, we have to make them like. So how can we make them like? See, if you have done LCM, you can take LCM. If you have not done LCM for junior classes, I have told you that we have to cross multiply the fraction with each other, right? See, like here 1 upon 2 minus 1 upon 3 is question. So here I will multiply first fraction with the 3. So we will cross multiply. We will multiply this with 3 and this with 2. So I will write 1 into 3, 2 into 3 minus 1 into 2, 3 into 2. So answer will be 1 3 ja 3, 1 2 ja 2 and 6, 2 3 ja 6 and 2 3 ja 6. Right? Then simple. Now they became like fractions. So we will simply subtract them. 3 minus 2 upon 6. So 3 minus 2 is 1. Then 1 upon 6 is the answer. Right? Then next question, 4 upon 7 minus 3 upon 6. Again, we will cross multiply. We will multiply 4 by 7 with 6 and 3 by 6 with 7. So 4 6 are 7 6 are and 3 7 are and 6 7 are. So answer will be 4 6 are 24 upon 7 6 are 42. 7 3 are 21 and 6 7 are 42. Now they became like fraction and then we will simply subtract them and what will they become? 24 minus 21, 3 upon 42. Then again, we will cancel them with 3. 3 1 ja 3 and 3 1 ja 3, 1 remainder, 3 4 ja 12. So answer is 1 upon 14. Understood? So you can, if you have done regular practice, you can easily understand that question because earlier we have done all these. So after this, I hope all is clear to you. Okay. The next question I have taken. See, I have taken more question of mixed fraction. Mixed and unlike fraction. So see, question is 9 1 upon 2 minus 8 3 upon 5. So see, first step. What we will do? We will make this mixed fraction into improper fraction. So that we have also done. That is 2 9 ja 18 plus 1 19. So we will write 19 upon 2. This time I am writing direct. 8 5 is 40 plus 3 43. So I am writing 43 upon 5. Then I will repeat this one. In this question we will do first time. So we will cross multiply as we were doing in previous questions. So 19 into 5, 2 into 5 and here 14 into 2 and 5 into 2. I think you can see. Okay, fine. Then 19 5 is 95 upon 10 and 86 upon 10. Calculation you should do yourself. Don't copy it from here. If you will copy the calculation, you will never learn how to do maths. Equal to 95 minus 86 upon 10. So 95 minus 86 is 9 upon 10. So this is the answer. We cannot cancel them because HCF is 1 and they are of different tables. We can just learn with our observation also. Next is 6 5 upon 8 minus 5 2 upon 4. So again, first we will change them into improper fractions. So 8 6 are 48, 48 plus 5 53 upon 8 minus 5 4 are 20, 20 plus 2 22 upon 4. Then we will cross multiply. So no, this time see 8 and 4. See 8 comes in the table of 4, right? So we can make this 4 8 by multiplying it by 2. So I have only multiply it because it is already 8. So we can make it 8. So I will do 22 upon 4 into 2 into 2. Right? Then here 53 upon 8 and 22 into 2, 44 upon 8. So now they became like fraction and we will simply subtract them. 53 minus 44 is equal to 9 upon 8 and 9 upon 8 is improper fraction. So we will change it into mixed fraction. So we will write 1, this is 8, 1 ja 8 and QRD form. This we have done also earlier. So 1, 1 upon 8 is the answer. So see, you have to do each and every question yourself. And if you are not very good in math and very perfect in calculation, you have to do each question 5 times continuously. Because first time you will understand it. Right? Second time you know how to do calculation. And then again and again if you will do, so you will be perfect. So if you want to become perfect in math, you have to do a single question continuously 5 times. So that each and every step is clear to you and your timing will be improved. In maths, timing is very important. If you will not do complete the paper in time, there is no use of doing questions, right? So be prepared for exam for future, and as I have told you, maths want practice. So maths need practice. If you are in practice, so every question will click in your mind. Or same question, if teacher has, it will give you a twisted question or same like this, if teacher will change digits, but if method is clear to you, you can do every question. Okay, so I hope you will practice honestly and be honest with you, then you will get success. Okay, so please like, share and subscribe my channel so that the motto with which I am making this video, I am making this video for that student which don't want to, which is shy, who is shy and who don't want to go for tuition, who don't want to discuss with anybody. So you can easily learn from my videos, and please share your feelings or share your problems relating to this maths in comment section. So I hope all is clear to you, and see you next class, and go successfully step by step, and have a nice day. Very good.